Hi, hello everyone, welcome back to our channel. In this video, we are going to solve the challenges in Big Object Basics module. And the first challenge is get started with big objects. Click on that. Now scroll down to the last. So it is off quiz challenge, and the first question is up to how many records can a big object hold? So the correct answer is option E. And the next question is, what is a good use case for a custom big object? And the correct option is option D. And the third question is, what is the best way to query big objects if you are working with an external large set of data? And the correct answer is batch apex. So like this, we selected the options for all the three questions and click on this check the quiz button. So yeah, the quiz is completed and we got the 100 points. So for moving to the next challenge, click on this tackle the next unit button. So the name of the second challenge is define custom big objects. Scroll down to the last. So here is the task that we need to complete. And first of all, change your hands-on org to My Trailhead Playground and click on this launch button. From here, move to the setup page. For this, click on this gear icon and then click on this setup button. So the page looks like this, and the task is about we need to create one of the custom big object, and also we need to create the custom fields in that. First of all, copy the label of the big object, that is rider history, and move to the setup page, and in this quick find search for big objects. Click on this. Now here click on this new button. So paste the label here and copy the plural label, that is rider histories, and add it here, and then click on this save button. So like this, we created the big object, and then we need to create the custom fields in that. So first of all, copy the label of the first custom field, that is start location latitude. And here in this custom fields and relationship, click on this new button. And here select the data type as number. Click on next. Now paste the field name. Start location latitude and change the length to 7 and decimal places to 4, and then click on this next button. Then click next and click on this save and new button. And the next field to be created is start location longitude, and here select the data type as number. And then click next. Now paste the label, and here change the length to 7 and decimal places to 4, and then click next. Click next again, click on the save and new button. And the next field is start time, so copy the label and here select the data type as date or time. Then click next, and here paste the label, and for this field select this required checkbox and then click next, next, and finally click on the save and new button. And the next field is end time, so copy and here select the data type as date or time, click next. Paste the label, then click next, next, and click on the save and new button. And the next field to be created is service type, so copy and here select the data type as text, click on this next button. Now paste the label here and type the length as 16. And then click on next, click next, and then click on the save and new button. And the next field is rider account, copy, and here select the data type as text, click next, and here paste the label and type the length as 16, and also click on this checkbox near to the required, then click next, next, and finally click on this save and new. And next, copy the label that is rider rating, and here select it as number, then click next, paste the label, and then change the length to 2 and decimal places to 1, click next, next, and then click on the save button. So like this, we created all the custom fields and relationship, and then we need to create the index. So copy the label that is rider history index. So move to the setup page, and if you didn't find this new button, then you have created the custom fields and relationship wrong. That is, for some of the fields we selected the required checkbox. If we didn't selected that required checkbox, then this new button will not appear for you. So do check out that, and now click on this new button, paste the label here, and then for this rider account select the index position as 1 and then index direction as descending, and for this start time select the index position as 2 and index direction as descending. So finally click on the save button. So here click on this back to rider history, and the final one is we need to deploy this rider history big object. For that, in this setup page click on this edit button, just scroll down to the last, and in this deployment status change it to deployed, and then click on this save button. So like this, we done all the required ones. Click on this check challenge button. So yeah, the task is completed and we got the badge. And please do check out our channel Education Matters for remaining module answers and super batch answers. And also please share our channel to your friends. It will help them too. That's it. Thank you.